Hello, my name is Andy Chatha. We are here at 27th ARC Industry Leadership Forum in Orlando. I'm delighted to have Antonio Pietri with us today. Antonio is President and CEO of Aspen Technology. Welcome, Antonio.
Very glad to be here, Andy.
Antonio, recently you completed a major transaction with Emerson Software. Mm-hmm. Could you tell us a little bit, how is that going to help you deliver more value to your customers?
Yeah, great. Well, thank you for that question. And the fact is that we're very proud of the transaction that we did with Emerson. Emerson has turned out to be a great partner. The thesis for that transaction was to really get AspenTech to scale, not only in addition to paying $6 billion they contributed to software businesses. So today, the new AspenTech is about 4,000 employees and $1.2 billion in revenue. So now we have a scale to be more acquisitive, which is the second part of the thesis for the transaction, really leverage Emerson's balance sheet to help AspenTech be more acquisitive in the market at scale. So we'll continue to drive organic software development innovation, but also do inorganic M&A in order to accelerate our growth and our expansion into asset intensive industries. The third part of the thesis was really for AspenTech to expand into new markets. So we, with the two software companies that they contributed, we're now into the utilities industry, transmission and distribution. We're into upstream oil and gas. So today, the new AspenTech can model the entire petroleum supply chain from the rock in the reservoir to the fuel distribution to gas stations. And then lastly, we've expanded our value proposition to your question from just profitability to profitability and sustainability. You know, being in the utilities industry is about global electrification, which is a key dimension of net zero carbon emissions. The upstream capabilities that we took on, we can also use for carbon capture and sequestration, for geothermal energy, and so on. And since we closed the transaction with Emerson, we've also announced a couple of acquisitions. Inmation, which we announced yesterday, is now renamed the DataWorks Business Unit, is an enterprise data management platform. And to me, the simplest way to frame Inmation is it helps bring order to data. We're hearing from customers that they really have a challenge with organizing their data, understanding the relationships between data, and that's what Inmation does. And then we, the other transaction that we've done since Emerson is a company called Micromine in the metals and mining space. Mm-hmm. And we're hoping to close that transaction soon. Mm-hmm. And really is now about digitalizing the mining industry, metals for electrification, mm-hmm. and the role that the new AspenTech can play more and more in sustainability.
Well, that's very impressive now. Also become, you have a quite diverse set of solutions. Now, as companies are trying to actually transform their operations and so forth and become more sustainable, mm-hmm. you know, how do you feel that all the combined portfolio will help them move faster in their journey?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. And it's what we're hearing from our customers. Now that we've been introducing the new AspenTech, they react in a very positive manner, that now they understand the portfolio of solutions that we can bring to bear around sustainability. And frankly, they are the ones telling us that they feel we're so uniquely positioned to help them in their own transformation in this energy transition into new business models or new areas. So look, historically, we've done efficiencies, and efficiencies now everyone recognizes that it's about reducing energy consumption, which reduces the CO2 footprint. We can do carbon capture and sequestration. We've now built capabilities to model for hydrogen production, hydrogen storage and transportation. We're also we've also introduced capabilities to do pyrolysis for circularity, or electrolyzers for the hydrogen production, but also biofuels. And then the capabilities, if you go far enough into the supply chain, and the metals for electrification. And ultimately, the capabilities that we took on from Emerson through this business, Open Systems International, around utilities, they have capabilities to manage the microgrids and also capabilities to manage the introduction of renewables sources of power into the grid and the intermittency of those sources of power. So our own industrial customers in oil and gas and chemicals are interested in those capabilities to manage their own microgrids, industrial or commercial grids, because of the complexity of renewables. So the consensus is AspenTech is now so well positioned around sustainability and also profitability, and that's how we're engaging our customers going forward.
Yeah, Aspen technology has always been very big on first principle models.
Correct.
That's your core business. Yeah.
Correct.
How do you merge that with all of these AI models that we are starting to see are come in? How do you actually combine and leverage them, take full advantage of both of these technologies? Could you elaborate on that?
Yeah, sure. Well, look, it's been a journey for us as well. To your point, historically, we've been a strongly rooted company on first principles of engineering, on the physics and the chemistry that sort of are the foundation to these processes. Now, artificial intelligence, while they've been around for a long time, those capabilities, it's only since 2015-16, we started doing research in this area to understand how we could leverage AI. And actually, it's through the work that we did with some other enterprise software companies where they were interested in modeling processes using AI, that it really gave us an insight into that they couldn't train the AI on the process itself because you cannot operate it across a full range of operations. So they asked us to use our modeling simulation tools to train their own AI. And eventually that experiment didn't work out. And what we concluded from that is that the real successful way to implement artificial intelligence in the process industries around complex and dangerous to operate processes is to embed artificial intelligence in the first principles solutions and have the first principles of engineering provide sort of the rules of the road, the guardrails to AI, so that it can operate within the safe operating envelope of these processes. And so we've now developed capabilities to develop these empirical data models using machine learning or deep learning that are then embedded in the first principles flow sheets to enhance the quality of the models, to enhance the predictability and the insights that these models provide. And our customers are reacting to it in a very good manner. So we think we have something that is good. Of course, there's a lot of companies out there trying just pure AI, and we'll see. The market will decide who's right.
All very impressive and very interesting, Antonio. Thank you very much. We have been speaking with Antonio Pietri, President and CEO of Aspen Technology. Thank you for watching.